first track off the In It For The Money EP is Cold Beer, Calling My Name. Wrote with my pals Hunter Phelps, Elisa Vanderheim, and Mr. Brett Tyler. We wrote this song actually, what, like 2017, I think? And it's funny, it took us like, I don't know, what, three times to finish it, I feel like?
Yeah.
Like two nights.
I mean, it's crazy. I mean, it's, you know, when we wrote it, we weren't thinking that it was gonna be a duet. So it's crazy having, you know, my buddy Luke jump on there with me and just really see it come to life since we wrote it. I think it was your idea?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like every song I record is Hunter's idea. It's pissing me off a little bit.
It was just calling my name in my phone, and I think, wasn't it like 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and we hadn't got anything mm-hmm. that day? I was way up in my titles, I mean, like years before.
Yeah.
I said, call my name, and I kind of jokingly just sang, there's a cold beer calling my name, and Brett heard it, and he was like, he kind of went into like, let's not mess this up mode, mm-hmm. you know? He was like, man, that's a smash idea.
Yeah, I just remember Lisa tripping out, just being like, this is my favorite song of all time.
It really was. Yeah.
Well, I think it was like, we knew it was cool, and I think, you know, when we started just kind of playing through it too, it was like, we didn't want to mess it up, but we also didn't want to make it too smart.
Yeah,
exactly. I feel like sometimes
it's
really hard, those simple songs that are just like sing-along and like easy going, sometimes they're the hardest ones to write because you don't want to make it so redundant that everybody's heard it before. So I feel like, you know, the verses especially, I think we put a lot more time into just like finding the right language and stuff like that.
Yeah, I mean, so it was just nuts. Like, I remember texting Luke, I was thinking, you know, there's no way he's going to jump on this. I just remember I was like, dude, no pressure, but it would be pretty cool. Mm-hmm.
We were in the Bahamas for that, you know, combustion trip, and you were like, Brett, I got something to tell you. And I was like, okay, what, you know, whatever. And you're like, I think there's going to be a duet on that song. And I was like, really? And I was like, who? And he was like, Luke Combs. And I was like, okay, all right.
I've yet to play a show, even with a number one song. The last show I played was last March, and, you know, my first single wasn't even in the top 40 yet. So
that's crazy.
The next show I played, Cold Beer, is going to be, it's in the top 40 now. And so Hunter said he's played it out at a writer's night. And just
I played it last night.
Oh, you played it last night?
Yeah.
Just talking about how a ton of people have already singing it. So we had a lot of fun writing this one. Pumped to see it going up the radio. Hope y'all are digging it too. New song humming and the sunset's doing this thing. Feeling lucky as a 7, yeah, sometimes heaven is a pocket full of payday green. One of the songs off my latest EP, In It For The Money, is a song called Good Dogs, which I wrote with my boys Hunter Phelps, Brent Anderson, and Jake Mitchell. I remember being a fan of Brent before I actually became a friend with Brent. Same kind of deal as some of the other songs. This one was written at the cabin and over east of Nashville on Center Hill Lake, and I remember Hunter having this idea, right?
Mm-hmm.
And Hunter got a dog, 2 or 3 years ago now? It was one of those, it was hard not to just cry when we were writing at the cabin.
It's probably like when you have a kid, like, because I just got a dog, so like when you have a kid, you naturally just like think of titles that, you know.
Trying to find a way to make it
exactly
what we want it to be, which is good dogs don't live long enough, but try not to make it so sad. It's like, how can you find a way to...
I remember when we got on comparing it to like all the good things that you have in life, and
I remember James.
That was when I got goosebumps when we were like getting on those lines, I remember.
Brent is an amazing guitar player, musician in general, but especially acoustic guitar. He's probably my favorite acoustic player in the world. He plays on all my stuff in the studio. He played on Good Dogs. Jake helped produce it.
After we cut that song in the studio, I remember it was like no one really said anything afterwards, but we all knew it was the perfect take.
You know, it definitely pulls on the heartstrings. I grew up with dogs. I don't have a dog at the moment just because it would be kind of unfair for me to have a dog right now as much as I'm gone. But for me, it just takes me back to a time with, you know, they're family members. You know what I mean? You grow up with dogs, they're family members after so long with them. So
something, there's somewhere in that second verse, there's something that's real sad that we got to talk, and I kind of go out on the porch and Hunter's on the porch. Ruth just standing there drinking beer and not saying anything at all.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, that song's sad. Yeah, it's real sad. Yeah, let's go back in there. Okay.
And the bridge is probably, it's my favorite bridge of any song ever that I've ever written.
It's kind of, it captures how important, how big of a deal I feel like a pet can be.
So obviously this song means a ton to all of us, and we somewhat had a blast writing it. I don't know if a blast is the right word. Good Dogs, y'all go check it out. Hope you like it. Good buddies will always come running, got your back no matter what. The good dogs don't live long enough. The EP wouldn't even exist without Some Girls. Some girls get their mama on the phone, take a trip back home, pretend they never knew the guy. Some girl drink a bottle of wine, got an old extra text to get them through the getting by sometime. And Some Girls is actually a song that is several years old. It was a song that, ironically, I didn't write. My buddies Hardy, Jake Mitchell, and CJ Solar wrote this song several years ago. And at the time, you know, we kind of came up together in Nashville. We moved to town around the same time. And you know, when you're coming up through the trenches together, you kind of share demos with each other along the way and get feedback from your buddies on songs that you write. And that was back when none of us really had a lot going on at the time. And so I fell in love with it, you know, all those years ago, and I always told them, man, if nobody ever cuts this song, I would love to do it one day if I ever got a record doing. So fast forward a few years and somehow that song slipped through the cracks and I got to record it. And man, what a journey that song has had. I mean, it's probably the reason I got a record deal. It's probably, you know, one of the reasons that I got on the Luke Combs tour. It's my very first number one song. It spent probably almost a year and a half at country radio, and I rang the bell, which was just crazy to see. I know it's such a rare thing for a new artist to have their debut single go number one. So I definitely wouldn't be sitting here talking about this EP if it wasn't for Some Girls. So man, just thankful for that song. Some girls get their mama on the phone, take a trip back home, pretend they never knew the guy. Some girls drink a bottle of wine, gotta know. In It for the Money is the title track off my new EP. Wrote it with my boys Hunter Phelps, Brent Anderson, Jake Mitchell. Caught a lot of hell when I left home with a guitar. This is another one that came from the cabin over on Center Hill Lake. All four of us kind of came up in Nashville together. Me, Hunter, and Jake, especially. You've been here since, what,
05.
I feel like I'm speaking for me. I'm probably speaking for all of them. I would do it for a just getting by salary. You know, if all I had to do was get up and play a guitar and write a song, I'd probably do it forever. You know what I mean? Even if I didn't make.
We have done that.
What do you mean?
Okay, so you're making money? Yeah.
What are you getting? What are they paying you, dude? From the first line of that song, it's real for all of us. Caught a lot of hell when I left home with a guitar. You're like, yep.
Yeah. Everybody thought we'd be coming back real
sure
quick.
Yeah. My favorite line of that song is, I guess we can cuss in this interview since you're doing the song, but bitch about the bed, the Motel 6 you stay.
Oh, yeah.
Because all I think about is this one trip that me and Hunter went on. Yep. I don't know if it was a Motel 6.
It was a budget 6 trip. It was a low-paying one.
Oh, man.
Imagine that.
Imagine that.
I think I was making about negative $1,200.
Yeah. They messed up rooms somewhere, and we had one room for Pete and Cam, yeah, a drummer and bass player. And then the guy comes to Hunter and he says, I've got one more room, but it's been smoked in.
I think about one of the, this was probably 4 or 5 years ago, I had a show in Myrtle Beach, opening for Low Cash, I think it was. We get to this hotel, and when we open the hotel door, the room, there's leaves all in the floor. The comforters had holes in them, this big, like all over the place.
Sounds like mice.
We pull up the sheet and shine our phone on it. There's literally bed bugs everywhere. I'm not joking. So we
climbed in bed.
So we went to bed, had a great night's sleep.
A little itchy the next morning.
It's that high you get when you hear people singing songs.
Yeah, that never goes away. That's the best part of it. Yeah, I think all of us relate to that song tremendously.
Absolutely. If you were in it for the money, like, you would have never started doing it in the first place.
This EP obviously means a ton to me. I haven't been able to release any new music for a while, so it's good getting to put some new songs out. But In It for the Money, I'm glad it was the title track. It's one of my favorite songs on the EP, and I think it's because all of us can relate to it so much, and hope y'all dig it. Looking at the world through an old man windshield, that long road to the top ain't paid with sold out shows. If I was in it for the money, I'd have quit a long time. Hunter's actually my oldest friend on the couch, but one of my oldest friends in Nashville. We met at the Commodore Grill back in, what, 2012?
Yeah.
We were talking at the bar, grabbed the beer, and, you know, we got to talking about deer hunting and all this stuff. So I was like, yeah, he's going to be one of us. So it's worked out over the years. And this song, where did this song even come from? I can't even...
You had the title.
I feel like me, Hunter, and Smith were writing another song.
Mm-hmm. It was like a liner.
And like the line came out, you know, Rolling Rock, Rolling Stones for another song. And then we were like, ah, that'd be a cool song.
Yeah, because you guys came in with that title.
Yeah,
that
we were
day.
Like, we should write it with Jake.
To my studio.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so we took it to Jake and it kind of just fell out. Pretty easy to write, I mean.
I feel like that was one of those days where it was effortless.
Yeah, we kind of tipped the hat to the Stones and the whole song, obviously. They're, you know, the song's about them and drinking beer, but... you know, I guess it's ironic that my first single was Some Girls and the Stones had a number one song called Some Girls Too, and we snuck it into the first verse.
Yeah.
Some girls out on the dance floor about to make a grown man cry. So it's just little tricks in there like that. I'm trying to think of another one. Start me up on a green bottle bus. Yeah. Like that was cool.
The bridge.
Honky Tonk Women.
The bridge. Yeah, the bridge was great. Wish this bar didn't close at one, but you can't always get what you want.
Yeah. Yeah. All the favorite Rolling Stone songs in one.
I also remember after we were done writing it, Jake was like building the track, and me and Hunter drove to Virginia's Market and got a six pack of Rolling
Rock. Right.
Oh, yeah, we did.
Oh,
yeah, we
did
drink Rolling Rock.
And we came back and had us a couple green bottles.
Got in the zone.
Yeah, we're not drinking.
Got a green bottle bus.
Yeah.
And then we did it in the studio too, like the day we cut it.
Yeah, I mean, in the studio, it was obviously. You know, the guys that played on the record are huge fans of rock and roll music and country music and the history of it. And it's kind of one of those songs where we had some tracks, I think, like pre-production where we went in, and then it was one of those songs where we were like, all right, who wants to be Keith?
Yeah.
You know, who wants to be Ronnie? And the two guitar players just kind of, we were like, jam out like you're the Rolling Stones back in the day.
Yeah, I mean, when you have a band that good, I mean, it's
amazing
you
know, musicians.
You just let them play.
And only took like one or two takes.
Yeah, and I feel like we let them groove for like a minute in the intro. Remember?
Yep.
We just kind of let them get a feel for the song, and then they just kind of jumped in. But definitely one of my favorites. Hope y'all dig it. Start me up on a green bottle bus. Talk about killing two birds at once. Drinking beer, singing songs, rolling. These are my boys. This is Josh Miller. This is Smith Onquist. Mr. Jake Mitchell over here. I feel like I met Josh through Brandon. Brandon Lay.
Jameson was roommates.
Yeah, me and Brandon. Yeah.
And I was still working a sales gig, and I would like get off of work and drive to Brandon's and sit around the kitchen table.
Yeah.
And us three wrote some songs, and that was how I met Jamo.
I can't remember how I met you, Smith. Was it through Hunter?
Through Hunter, yeah.
I think you and Hunter had met.
I've been writing
Ashley?
With,
yeah. He's from the same town as Ashley Gorley, another songwriter that's had a couple hits here.
I've never heard of him. He's on the come up.
Yeah.
And you worked for Ashley for a while, didn't you?
And Ashley
ended up signing Hunter. And, you know, me and Hunter had been tight for a while, and
yeah.
That's how you and Hunter met, and then eventually me and Hunter started writing. And Jake, back when I met Jake.
We met randomly on just a random
co-write. We just got scheduled to write one day. And I walked in, and Jake had a little top hat on.
Yeah, I used to wear the old flat brim.
Oh snap!
The East Nashville hat.
Yeah,
color.
you had the little top hat, a lot of hair all the way down to his ass.
It's almost there again.
I was like, man, who is this hippie boy I'm about to write with? But we wrote a cool song that day, and then
we didn't see each other for quite a while.
You
I think.
And Hardy were tight at the time.
Well, and you lived downstairs from him.
Yeah,
and then. We'd wrote, but I didn't see you for probably a year or more after
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then organically, it kind of like this circle of buddies, like us three and Hunter and Brent, and it was a bunch of us that kind of had our like little own fraternity almost called the Band of Bros or whatever. Yeah. So,
we hung out
pretty much
all
just
time,
an excuse to party
before
all the time.
We got too old to hang out, you know.
We're too busy.
I've rented a cabin over east of Nashville for like the last 3 or 4 years, and we go camp out for 4 or 5 days and write a bunch of songs, and this is just one that kind of came from that trip. This was like the first, was it the first retreat we did there?
Yeah, yeah, very first.
That's
one.
What I thought. And it was like maybe the first song we wrote, right? Because we
first
we got
night
there,
we got there. Yeah.
And I think you were just like, I thought, let's just write a song called Mississippi or something.
Yeah, I feel like I had was, like when you think of, yeah. I don't, I might have had Tennessee in my phone.
Yeah.
That's where I'm from, but knowing J-Mo, he's a Mississippi boy, so we had to make it about Mississippi.
We started with Mississippi, and I think Jake picked up the electric guitar and started playing that groove, maybe.
Yeah, we had that little rock vibe.
I feel like we usually start with like a title and how you're gonna do the title, and that one I feel like we just started writing and it just kind of fell out.
Kind of wrote like a rock song almost.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I think we might have struggled with a little while trying to think of the angle of the girl.
Just trying to make it a little
different.
We
decided to kind of make her the West Coast, like she left the little town.
Yeah.
Like, I remember Jake had a couple zingers in there that made that hook pop.
This song's literally like, when did we write this? 2018?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It just kind of takes a while sometimes for songs to kind of get their shot. So I started just loving pretty much every song that I wrote with Jake, and so it just made sense for him to start helping produce some of my, all of my stuff. So I'm just pumped that, you know, that cabin, the magic in the air at that cabin kind of produces some of these songs, and I'm glad it produced When You Think of Mississippi, and glad I got to write it with some of my best buddies here. Do you still sound like you're from this town that you swore you'd never leave? Girl, I miss you, wish you were with me. Do you ever miss me when you think of Mississippi? Life's kind of funny, but it doesn't always make you laugh. Sometimes a punchline doesn't hit you till you're looking back. This was your idea, wasn't it, Josh?
Yeah, I think I had it in my phone.
But I remember we were writing another song that I was digging.
It's like, that's why we're here. Or something like
right.
That.
Yeah,
it was pretty cool.
Yeah, and so I went upstairs and I was talking with Falcon, got a drink or something, and came back down and they were starting Desert.
Yeah.
Kind of messing around with
and
it.
And I was like, wait, what about the other song? And anyway, I ended up forgetting about the other song pretty fast.
It's like an old proverb or something like that.
Yeah.
It was sunshine all the time makes a desert.
Yeah.
Or something like that. And so I just kind of threw that concept in my phone.
Yeah.
And threw it out to the guys. And
it was one of those moments where, like, you're tired and I could have gone to bed, but then it's like, this is too good.
Like, I feel like sometimes when you're tired, and I mean, we had a few beers and it was late.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes when you're in that like sleepy state, you almost like
it's sometimes where the
you don't
best
think
magic
so
is.
Hard
yeah.
and you just say something
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
And those desert rhymes like came out organically.
Yeah.
I feel like.
Yeah. And it's like it's probably hard to believe that we didn't write that during a pandemic. You know what I mean? But we actually wrote it, I guess,
2 years ago.
2 years before a pandemic, and it turns out to to fit the current. Life situation. Perfectly right now. It's just like, the one of the lines in the chorus is, the lows sure make the highs better. And, last year was definitely a low for probably most people. And so, hopefully this song will, put some people in a good mood. Hope y'all dig it. You know the lows sure make the highs so much better. Man, sunshine all the time just makes a desert.